Hello guys, welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's February 15th, 2021, and this is where we begin. We have a Mankey old well, galvanized pipe, Schedule 40 PVC, you know, swimming pool pipe, and a flex light tank of unknown vintage. And a lot of ugly and crappy wire and ugly valves and just this is pretty much par for the course for a well in America, like, but it's pretty bad. Our pressure gauge is way up here, our pressure switch, pressure gauge, schedule 40. I don't even know. There's several vintages of things happening here. But I'm about to pull all this out and replace it with this and build a whole new system. So let's dive into plumbing. This will be great. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fun.
We actually have a service disconnect on the wall now. That's progress.
Actually,
it's going to be clean, clear water coming out. It's the same water we drink.
Wow.
All right, so it's going to be clean, clear water coming out. It's not sewage.
Mostly iron.
Yeah.
This is where we drink the handle off the belt.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Garbage.
That was totally not just hanging there.
Okay.
That's trash.
Well, I was trying to be my best.
Like a beautiful ballet. Okay, that is garbage.
This is the wellhead.
Yeah.
This is the casing, which is just a hollow pipe that goes all the way down.
Yeah.
Under here is a piece of pipe, and that's called the drop pipe. Hanging on the bottom of that pipe is a big stainless steel pump, okay? But it hasn't been moved in a long time, and it's going to be covered in iron and schmoo. If we smack this or jostle this a lot, we're going to knock all that rust through, and we're going to have to sanitize the well, and that's a really big pain in the ass. So everything we do here has to be very deliberate, slow, and gentle, okay? What we're going to do is lift this up about this high. That's it.
All right.
Then I'm going to put two clamps under it. And what the clamps do is protect us from the worst case scenario, which is if that pipe falls, $5,000, don't have water for a week, bad, bad, bad.
All right.
So we're going to lift it up about this high, very slowly. I'm gonna put a clamp on it and then another clamp above that just in case one slips or something.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna hold the pipe with the wrench and we're gonna unscrew this. It should be pretty easy because it's a plastic pipe, so this shouldn't have too much purchase on it. Once this is off, I'm gonna clean it with a wire brush. I'm gonna put on new tape, new pipe goop, and we're gonna spin one of these on. I'm not sure which size it is. If it's this size, it just goes on. If it's this size, then I gotta transfer this fitting over to here, which will take me like 5 minutes. Okay?
I assume all of the stuff you just described after the clamping parts, we are not actively holding the
pipe. No, the clamps will hold the pipe.
Okay.
So step one, very gently, we're gonna lift this together.
Okay.
You're gonna lift and hold it. I'm gonna put the clamps on. Okay? So grab here and here. You don't wanna angle it. This is a giant pendulum in a 4-inch pipe.
Yeah.
So we're just going to lift mainly here, and we're just going to come straight up about 6 or 8 inches. So
do you know how heavy it is?
It's not very heavy, so ease into it. Beautiful. Just come right on up, a little bit more. Is that, or is that all the further up it'll let
that's
go?
All it'll go.
That's all it'll go? All right.
Well, then I can pull harder. But
don't. Yep. Don't force it. We'll stay right here, and I'll just put the clamp right on at this position. It means we're working a little tight, but we'll be okay. And once I get the clamps on, once I get the first clamp on, it should be able, it'll hold itself properly. And the second clamp's just for safety. Okay, let go easy and see if it stays.
Don't move.
Cool. All right. So I'm gonna put this clamp on, let go. I'll put this clamp on above it, 90 degrees off.
What?
I didn't know what size the pipe would be because I couldn't see it. So I got two different size clamps because they cost $2. So I find it, buy both sizes, be sure. Because what I didn't want to do is end up in a situation where the water was off, the pipes were cut apart, and we couldn't do the job.
Right.
Sit right on top of each other. Are you fucking kidding me? We gotta be careful. I can't just reef these down.
Plastic
pipe. That ends bad. Just the lightest of fingertip pressure. Okay. Now we gotta do is spin this off of that. Grab that big wrench. I'm gonna hold the pipe. Like this pipe. You're gonna hold that pipe and use that pipe as a wrench. And it should, in theory, let me make sure I got a good pipe.
I'm gonna move.
Just settle down. Okay. Now the goal here is that that pipe don't turn.
Okay. We want this whole thing to turn, right?
Yeah. But I need to be... Okay. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Please clear the wall, you fuck. Can you squeeze that around the wall?
No. Geometrically, no. Because if I go past 90, it's going to be even longer.
Hold this.
Okay.
Don't let it move. Okay.
Well, probably because it's not that easy, huh?
This is going to be a lot harder to turn because it's going to be corroded to shit. There's a solution.
You don't want to cut it, do you?
I don't want to go at it with the sawzall because it's going to... So...
Pipe bender?
No. I know how to do it.
Why don't we just turn the whole pump?
We don't want to move everything down there. Because we knock all the iron loose.
Right.
But I know how to cut that off without shaking everything. It's just going to take a couple minutes. If the War of the Currents went differently, do you think Watts riots could have had a whole different meaning? Cutting off a giant inch and a quarter pipe with a fucking Dremel. Anywhere's walking distance if you got the time. Okay. Now we just spin that right off. I need your help on that. Nice and smooth, right on around. Ooh, the end of that's kind of toasty.
Yeah. There. Oh, that's full.
Right away. Yeah, that's a good thing. It means our check valve's working. See something really exciting. There's power to that wire right now. All right, I think we're this size. So it wants to go in there. All right.
On his table.
Next table's gonna be a little bit more substantial. That comes out. This goes in. Now I know the top is already tight. Still, we're gonna check it just to be sure. We'll add some Blue Monster tape. Somebody's gonna comment and be like, you're bleeding and dealing with water supply stuff. It's like, dude, that was the worst thing in our water right now. This one last as long as the last one did. Ah, okay, that's on there. And just for safety, this and goop. And the pipe is still there, so that's good. Give me the wire brush that's over there, please. There's a little plastic wire brush. This works while wet, right? Totally. Okay. Okay. Steven?
Yeah?
Can you not let the pipe move?
Alright.
I'm gonna go get another wrench. I'm gonna spin this on hand tight first just for safety. And then I'm gonna go get another wrench. And we're gonna have competing wrenches. And to all the people who are asking me why I didn't wipe my shmoo off there yet, because I wanted to get the fitting on just tight enough to know that that couldn't fall down the fucking hole. Good news is we're past the danger part. At least the big danger part. Now, unless something really weird happens, there's no way that we can just drop that down the hole. So we'll clean our shit off. Now we can easily get to it. Get this all nice and tidy. About the rest of that in a minute. Okay. All you gotta do is not move.
Yep.
While this is a nice, easy, smooth, simple process. We should stop there or go one more turn.
You're the one feeling it. I assume it has to end up being this way.
It's certainly best if it does.
Mm.
And if I over tighten it, it's really bad, so. Yeah, that's tight.
I'm gonna
go that way.
Call it good.
Alright, take your wrench off. Because we're gonna drop down into the thing.
Yeah.
Alright. We have now installed the new well head.
Cool.
Which is a pretty big deal, probably. It was my first time. Is it good for you? Thank you. Let her sit down.
It's sitting on the lip of the
pool. That's fine. That's where it was sitting before.
Okay.
It's sitting, and it won't fall down the hole.
I don't know how, but it's harder to hold me.
You want to get all the way?
Yeah.
For our next trick, we're gonna lay this on its back. Right here. So these are down down. And we're gonna rotate it until I have the output. Which, okay, we're gonna pick it up, rotate 90 this way. One more. Okay, right there. Old galvanized to new stainless. Welcome to the 20th century. Hold that. Gotcha.
Supposed to look like, or was that a brush once?
No, that is a brush. It's always supposed to look like that. This is exactly the way it looked the day I bought it.
It is viscous plumbing bird shit, yes. But it is made of magic. There are guys that use only this, and there are guys that use only tape. I use both because I'm very much a belt suspenders kind of guy on this. If you use just this, it almost never leaks. If you use just tape, it almost never leaks. If you use both, it really most sincerely almost never ever leaks. Okay, sir, can you please hold that ring? Yeah. This is a totally different version. My bow ring is good, no nicks, no scratches or cuts. Bigger little gob of that in there. Spread out relatively evenly. Excess off on the threads and sides. Okay. Let's have some of the fall, turn it inside out so yes. Okay. Coming at you. Now, let that go down to there. This just so. And you hold that so it don't fuck off. Very, very cognizant of not cross-threading the fucking thing. There we go. That's the only one. Okay. Are we level? Sight that line with the bent fucking tank and the top one. Good. I'm going to give this just a little kiss with this. Because this is not a place to reef on it. Just a quarter turn. That should do. Stand her up. We don't grab by this, by the way. We can grab it by the bottom, not the top. Okay, just come right on up. Make sure you hit nothing. Okay. Now we scooch this to there. You want to have this line?
Yeah.
No, just come back a little bit to the wall.
Okay.
Okay, that's good. I want to have come about another inch off the wall. I want to have just a little bit of space because I don't want any wall condensation. So, all right, stop there. Is this perpendicular this line to the wall?
It is at least parallel to the edge of the well, which may or may not be perpendicular to the wall.
So now I gotta get from here into here in the best way. And that might be out 90. I didn't really want to go into the room, but that's put that there. That. So I come out into a 90, down into a 90, and then out. And I think that's the best way to do it. In 5 minutes, you can put full pressure in. Okay, so that's going to come off of there. I'm going to make another one of those, another stubby. There's a stop inside one end of these. This on an elbow, and then line it up to here where we want it on the right angle. And then we'll put an elbow on, and then we'll cut it and put an elbow on here. Actually, I'll put this stubby on here, because that'll give me the angle for my elbow up here. And then we'll cut it and pop it on. That's the plan. This one will go down here, and yeah, okay. Box out the way. Let's get rid of there. So here, ring. Let me get my angle established, and then I'll know the angle for this to put that on there. All right. There is no time. And these are really easy to make these connections. They're really hard to take apart. This is very much an instant commitment. All right, so now we know our angle. Ring. It really sucks if you do that first expansion without getting a ring on. I've never done two. You can get a ring on after doing the very first expansion, but you gotta want it bad.
Is that why you're here in Mexico?
Uh-huh. And get our angle right. That needs to be tighter, but that's perfect. All right, now we know exactly where to cut it.
How are we gonna get it on there?
Tank wiggles back.
Okay.
Also, the pipe is flexible-ish. It is somewhat bendy. You can wiggle this around. That definitely needs some tighter though. Plus the well moves a little bit.
everything's flexible. The old days of Iron Pipe are dead. Dead. Shit. Alright, we're gonna take this off of here. Because...
Okay.
Because I gotta be... I can't... I don't need to get a second chance.
Right.
So... we're gonna... hustle that. Oh, because he has... Because we can muscle that fucking thing. Just don't let the clean O-ring bit touch anything, okay?
Okay.
So you're the guardian of that assembly. Alright. You good?
Yes.
Okay. So we're gonna come right down and whoop when the moment is right. Commitment. All the way in. Yep, we're good. Okay, good joint. Just wait, just let this do its thing, and
sure.
Then we'll have that fight. I just want to give it a moment to do polymerization and whatnot. I have a very wet leg now. Damn, gross. How's that for a difference from the old system, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Everything's non-ferrous. Nothing here will rust. There's only one really bad design choice here, and I didn't realize it until a couple days ago. I needed a different color to differentiate hot, cold, raw. So for raw water, I went with white. It's translucent, which means this is gonna turn orange.
Mm.
Okay, come in. Now pit. Put a wrench on that, and we'll need two wrenches. I'm gonna get the other wrench so that we can tighten that better this time.
One over here.
I think that's too big to fit down there.
Oh.
I hope that's big enough. Oh yeah, we're plenty big. Grab the pipe wrench. Ah! Yes, that one. All right.
This way.
I see it. You're going this way.
Okay.
Okay. No, not the pipe, the ring.
Oh!
Yeah. No, I'm holding this to keep this from moving. You're just tightening the ring. And it doesn't have to be terribly tight because you got the big nubs. So go down, take another bite. Go down, slide in, come up. And come on, yep, like that. And take another bite, slide in, yep. Like a derailleur. Make sure loose. Taking little bites till it feels right.
I don't know what feels right. We've been doing like plastic pipe all day.
Yeah. That feels right. Can I turn it? No, I can't turn it now, so. I just can't get me through that. Okay. All right, that part of the system is done. Now we just gotta connect to the output house washer. Okay. All of the main connections are now done. Ta-da. So what we're going to do before we patch into the house is I'm going to grab just a length of generic three-quarter pipe and stick it on the end of this, and we're going to run it through the manhole out into the yard and just blow 50 gallons of water out of this thing, maybe 100, just to flush any schmoo that we've rattled loose out. That just seems better than injecting that into our water system.
Oh.
Just keep going. Mm-hmm. You're going to get a little water out of that, but not a lot.
Oh.
Keep going. Also, the water is unpressurized, which is good. So, we ready to chop that. Oh, we can do that. You ready?
Yep. Chop that console for what?
Oh, okay. There won't be much water here. And I can't stand on that. From the end, push. Here. Just push. Everything you got. Lean on that sumbitch. There you go. That's where I wanted to be. Let me turn the water off. Okay. All right. From there, we're going into the three-quarter pipes, which is now seated. Okay, cool. That makes it easier to get into the bucket if we have to again. I'm the Goyim Moil. It's yours.
No!
What?
It's gotta be perfect. It's either perfect or it's shit.
Yep, we're good. We're good. I just had to lean on that fucker. Okay, at this point, it should be watertight. Which means if I close this, we'll build up pressure in the tank, which we don't want to do. Because I don't want to put shit water right into the tank. I want this to just flash right on by.
Okay.
A little bit will go into the tank, but not a lot. We're not going to build up any pressure in there. We're just going to come right out of the pump, and right on outside, just flush it right out. All right. Are you good? Good, bud? You're good. Okay. I'm going to let go of that now. And that's happy. That is our new main water valve. You gotta put the valve after the tank because this is a pressure switch that tells the pump to turn off. So if you put a valve here, this will say I'm not getting pressure and this will just deadhead and you'll melt down the pump. You ready? Okay, time is 5 o'clock. Let's try it. Here you go! We're moving water! I'm only mildly terrified, but, you know, seems to work. And we're just running it right on up and flushing it. How's the color?
Looks normal.
Yeah? No texture or nothing?
Yeah.
All right, we're just going to let it go for 5 minutes. It might just be fine.
I mean, it smells like farts, but our water always
works. Yeah, it smells like farts, but... we're fixing that. This is the first step towards fixing that. How about that shit? It works.
All right, boys and girls, time is 1:45. The system is holding steady pressure and kicking on and off. So, yeah, it works. This is just temped in for the night. I gotta wire that up with way better wire and do a good job of this tomorrow, but this is what I have on hand. It's the original old well wire. I wanna clean that up, make it a lot prettier and a lot better. And of course, this goes to a little disconnect here, a little 20 amp disconnect, and then from there, that'll go to the main breaker box to a GFCI breaker on the, our breaker box has a neutral bus, so it's the plug-on neutral, it's really cool. But that'll go to a proper GFI breaker, unlike the original setup. Of course, when this went in, GFI breakers didn't exist yet, but that's the well head. We'll be back tomorrow for more fun and adventure of cleaning up the electrical, and I'll put this in a conduit and just sleeve it up pretty, and this will all be in seal tight, and it'll be good, but this will get us through the night. At least we got running water. And don't mind the big jank up the wall. That's just temp. That's all going to go away because that is going to feed over to part two, the filter bank. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you tomorrow.